This video is going to go over some of the problems that you will see on the 9.1 on your own assignment. So number one tells us that Preston earns $33 for babysitting his neighbor's children for 2.4 hours. So first we want to write an equation that is going to represent how much he earns per hour. So this is the total amount of money he earned. This is the total amount of hours. So I want to find the money per hour. So if I have my money here and we have our hours on the bottom. So I always just like to set up these proportion problems because they help me think about what am I doing. So I know that I got $33 and that was for 2.4 hours. So now I want to know how much 1 hour, so if I have 1 hour, how much money did I earn? So I'm going to do 33 times 1, so 33, and then I'm going to divide that by 2.4, and that's going to equal my M for the amount of money that I'm going to earn each hour. We could also write that as a multiplication problem. And I could say that I get for 2.4 hours, this is the money I earn, and that total is $33. So both of these are equivalent equations that can help us answer how much Preston earned per hour. So when we do 33 divided by 2.4, that tells us the money he earned every hour. When we do 2.4 times the money he earned each hour, then that will equal 33. So if we use this second equation here, 2.4m's equals 33, then it wants to know how much does he earn. So I need to get m all by itself, 2.4 times m. So that means I need to divide both sides of the equation by 2.4. So over here, it canceled out, so I'm just left with M. So I need to do 33 divided by 2.4. I've got to move the decimal, move the decimal. So I'm really doing 330 divided by 24 will tell us how much money he earned every hour. Hey, number three. Hey, so Carlos has 6 mugs on a shelf as shown. So you can see they're all different, but they all have the same weight. We just don't know what that weight is. This expression, 6, so that's representing the 6 mugs. This X is representing this weight that we don't know. And 84 is representing the total ounces they weigh together. So what visual model can we use to solve this equation? So we want to think about if we use these ounces to draw out a line and say, right, if we have 84 centimeters, every 1 centimeter, so 1 centimeter equals 1 ounce. So let's come down here. So use a ruler to draw a scale model of the image that is equal to 84 centimeters. Then measure. So yeah, you could draw this out, but I would have to exactly duplicate each of those mugs to the correct size. That sounds pretty challenging. So I don't know that just drawing a picture and measuring them is our best idea. So this one says we should draw 6 circles. So, okay, we're going to represent each of the 6 mugs. Sounds good. And then draw 84 dots inside each of the circles. Oh, okay. So I'm not going to draw 84 dots in here, but this is saying that this one mug weighs 84 ounces. But I can see up here that the total of all of them is 84. So if I was sharing the 84 dots, one here, one here, one here, and so on, till I finished all 84, that would make sense. But I do not want to put 84 dots in each of them. So here it says to draw each mug on top of each other, but they're not all the same. And so that isn't really going to help me. Okay. So So this one says to draw a bar model with a length of 84. Okay, so I have a model up here that is 84. And then divide the bar into smaller bars. So here, if I take this and I divide each of these to have 6, I could take 84 and I could cut it into 6 pieces. And that would help me figure out this problem. So I'm going to let you finish the rest of those for number 3. Hey, number 5, we want to find the solution. So we do not know this variable. So that's the solution we're looking for is x. So we have 1.9 times x. So we want to do the opposite of multiply, which is to divide by 1.9 on this side. And to keep it equal, divide by 1.9 on the other side. So 1.9 divided by 1.9 is just left with 1. We have 1x all by itself. So over here, we need to move our decimal each one place. So we just want to get this one to the end. So 47.5 divided by 19 will tell us the solution to x. So we'll see how many times we know it can't go into 4. So I know 19 is really close to 20. 19 is one away from 20. So it's practically 20, 40, 60. So I'm thinking it can't go in there 3 times. So I'm thinking it's going to be 2 here. So 2 times 19, if you go ahead and finish and solve that problem, you may need to add another 0 on the end there if necessary. Okay, so let's move on to number 8. So number 8 tells us that Glenn is 8 feet tall. He is 4/5 as tall as his brother. So these problems always confuse me. So I'm going to draw some pictures here. So here is brother, and it tells me that Glenn is 4/5 as tall. So if I take the brother, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, those aren't perfectly even, but I get the point here. And Glenn is only 1, 2, 3, 4/5. So this part right here is Glenn, and this whole thing is the brother. And I know Glenn is 5 feet tall. So the first thing we want to do is write an equation to represent the height. So I know that we have 4/5. And when I multiply that by the brother, so write an equation to find the brother's height. So I know that when I do 4/5 and multiply that by x, 4/5 of the brother is actually going to give me a smaller number, and that will equal Glenn. When we multiply by fractions, we get smaller numbers because the pieces are not a whole thing. So this is 4/5 of the brother. He is 5 feet tall. This is 4/5 of the brother. 4/5 of means to multiply of the brother, but it wants us to use x for the brother. So 4/5 of x equals 5. So now we want to solve for x here. So this is 4/5 times x. So we need to undo multiplication by dividing on both sides. We want to divide by 4/5. So I'm going to take 4/5 and divide it by 4/5. So 4 divided by 4 is 1. 5 divided by 5 is 1. This cancels out, so this is gone now. But we have to do that same thing to this other side. So we're taking 5 and dividing it by 4/5. So how can we solve for x? Well, we can divide both sides by 4/5. So that's how we'll solve, and now we'll actually do that. So 5 divided by 4/5. So 5/1. And so 5 divided by 4 is not something I can do nicely. And 1 divided by 5 is also not going to come out to a nice number like this one. So what I can do instead is the multiplicative inverse. I can copy, dot, and flop this around. So now I'm going to multiply. It's the same problem, but multiplying is going to be a lot easier than trying to divide 5 divided by 4. So 5 times 5 is 25. 4 times 1 is 4. And then we can simplify and see how many times 4 goes into 25 to finish that problem and see our fraction here. So this will tell us X, and that is how tall the brother is. So when I'm doing things like this, like I just really have to think about, okay, I know the brother's taller. So if I thought maybe I needed to divide something and I wrote my equation different, maybe I said 5X equals 4/5, and I do this problem and I get a number that doesn't make sense. Like maybe it says the brother is 1.7. Well, I know the brother's got to be taller. Or maybe it says the brother is 20 feet tall. Like those answers aren't going to make sense. I know the brother's just a little bit taller. So if Glenn is 5 feet, the brother should be just a little bit taller than that. Okay, so let's move on to and skip to number 13 here. So number 13 says that we have 9/5 x equals 2 7/10. So this is 9/5 times this. So the opposite of times is to divide. So 9/5 divided by 9/5. And I want to do that to both sides. So I always want to put that at the end. So 9 divided by 9 is 1. 5 divided by 5 is 1. So these are nice fractions that are going to divide. 1 divided by 1 is 1. So now this is gone and I have 1x, which is exactly what I want, 1x. So now we have 2 7/10 and we are dividing 9/5. So we need to make this improper here. To know how many pieces there are to divide the pieces. It's a lot easier to divide pieces rather than wholes. So we're breaking this whole into 10 pieces. So 10 times 2 is 20 plus 14 is 27 over 10. And then we're dividing by 9/5. So I want to copy, dot, flop. Actually, these numbers are working out really nice. Let's try it without copy, dot, flopping first. So I can see 27 and 9 are have a common factor. So I can do 27 divided by 9 is 3, and 10 divided by 5 is 2. This one worked out that I can do it. Let's try doing the inverse here, and let's copy, dot, and flop. So now I'm going to multiply, but I don't want to multiply 27 times 5. So I can see that I can do some simplifying here. 10 and 5 have a common factor of 5. So it goes in there 1 time and 2 times. 9 and 27 have a common factor of 9, goes in there 1 time and 3 times. 3 times 1 is 3. 2 times 1 is 2. So in this case, it was easier to divide. But if we had 27 divided by 8 and 10 divided by 7, if that was the problem, I can't do 27 divided by 8 evenly. And I can't do 10 divided by 7 evenly. So when this is the case, this is when we want to use that inverse and use that copy dot flop. So either way, we have 3/2. We're just going to double check that it works. 9/5 times 3/2. 9 times 3 is 27. 5 times 2 is 10. Well, here we had 27 over 10, which was 2 7/10. So our solution is 3/2, or we can simplify that to make it 2 goes into 3 one time with 1/2 left over. Hey, if you need any other help on this on your own, be sure to let me know and we can set up a time to meet together.